The world is made up of 5 oceans and 7 chunks of land called continents. North America, South America, Antarctica, Europe, Africa, Asia, and Australia. North America is the world's 3rd largest continent. It is made up of 3 large countries, Canada, United States of America, Mexico, as well as Greenland, the 7 countries in Central America, and the many Caribbean islands. There are 23 countries in North America. The continent of North America is made up of 6 main regions: Greenland, Canada, the United States, Mexico, Central America, and the Caribbean islands. Some islands are their own countries with their own governments, but some islands are governed by other countries. Greenland, for example, belongs to Denmark. Puerto Rico belongs to the United States. Canada is the continent's largest country. It is also the 2nd largest country in the world after Russia. The smallest country is St. Kitts and Nevis. The land of North America takes many shapes, from mountains to deep canyons to low-lying plains. The peaks of Rocky Mountains or Rockies stretch through the western region of North America about 2,000 miles into Mexico. The towering Rocky Mountains are covered with snow most of the year. Dozens of national parks lie along the Rocky Mountains in Canada, the United States, and Mexico. Thus, Rocky Mountains are the backbone of the continent. North America's Grand Canyon is the largest canyon in the world. Its deep valley was carved out by the Colorado River. A volcano is a kind of mountain that can throw hot, melted rock, ashes, and gases from inside Earth. Mexico has many volcanoes. Popocatépetl is one of the active ones. Although it smokes, the mountain top is covered with snow all year long. Mount McKinley is not only the highest mountain in the United States, it is also the highest mountain in North America. Flat-topped towers of layered rock called mesas are found in deserts and canyons of southwestern United States. North America has many large rivers and lakes. Canada has many lakes and inland water than any other country in the world. The Mississippi River and the Missouri River flow across the lower half of the continent. These two major rivers are the longest rivers in North America. The Niagara River flows from Lake Erie to Lake Ontario, a distance of just 35 miles. It serves as a part of border between the United States and Canada. At the river's midway point, water spills over a steep cliff forming Niagara Falls. The Great Lakes are the largest group of freshwater lakes on Earth. They form part of the border between Canada and the United States. The 5 Great Lakes from west to east are Superior, Michigan, Huron, Erie, and Ontario. Lake Superior is the largest freshwater lake in the world. Lake Nicaragua is the largest freshwater lake in Central America. Salt Lake City in United States is built on the dried out bed of a huge salt lake. Climate is the average weather a place has from season to season, year to year. Rainfall and temperature play large parts in region's climate. Because North America stretches from above the Arctic Circle to below the Tropic of Cancer, it has a wide range of climates. A region's climate depends upon 3 major things: how close it is to the ocean, how high up it is, and how close it is to the equator. Areas along the ocean have milder climates than areas farther inland. The higher a region is and the farther it is from the equator, the colder its temperature. The United States is so large that it has 6 different kinds of climate. Its northernmost places have a cold polar climate, while its southernmost places have a hot tropical climate. The continent of North America has some of the hottest and coldest temperatures on Earth. In July 1913, Death Valley in United States recorded the second hottest temperature in the world. It was 134 degrees Fahrenheit. In February 1947, Snag, Northwestern Canada recorded the third coldest temperature on Earth, and it was minus 81 degrees Fahrenheit. Much of Canada and one-fourth of United States has a continental climate. This region has four separate seasons: a cool spring and fall, a warm to hot summer, and a cold winter. In fall, when the weather gets colder, the leaves of the trees such as maple turn red and gold and drop to the ground. Maple trees are the most colorful in fall. In the far northern parts of North America, the Arctic winter is long, dark, and cold. At night, the sky often lights up with shimmering colors known as the Northern Lights. The Northern Lights glow in many different colors. Because of its many ecosystems, North America is home to a wide variety of plants. An ecosystem is all of the living and non-living things in a certain area. It includes plants, animals, soil, weather, everything. Plants such as cactuses have adapted to the hot, dry conditions of North America's desert ecosystems by storing water. Prairie grasses have deep roots so that they can survive wildfires. Forests of evergreen, maples, and other hardy trees can be found across one-third of the continent. Many different types of animals live in North America, and they are all well adapted to the ecosystems in which they live. An ecosystem is all of the living and non-living things in a certain area. Moose, bears, and other animals that live in North America's tundra ecosystems have thick fur to keep them warm through the long winters. In the desert, animals such as coyotes have light-colored fur that reflects the hot sunlight and keeps them cool. More than two-thirds of North America's population live in cities. Mexico City is the most populated city on the continent. Most North Americans live near bodies of water. The water can be used for power, for jobs, and for fun. It can also be used to grow crops and to transport goods and people. There are large areas in North America where very few people live. For example, few people want to live in Northern Canada, where winters are long, cold, and dark. San Francisco, United States is home to about 750,000 people. One of the city's most famous areas is Chinatown. Many Chinese families live there. Santo Domingo, Dominican Republic is the second largest city in the Caribbean. Located on the country's southern coast, the city of about 4 million people is a major part. Montreal is a busy Canadian port city. Located on the banks of St. Lawrence River, Montreal is a center for industry, business, and culture. Nearly 3.5 million people live there. One of the biggest cities in the world, Mexico City, Mexico, is home to about 20 million people. It was built on the site of an ancient Aztec city. In most Central American and Caribbean countries, about half of the population lives in the country's capital cities. The people of North America are a mixture of many different cultures from around the world. Together with the Native Americans, they make the continent an exciting place to live. Spanish culture. Mexico, Central America, and many of the Caribbean islands were once ruled by Spain. Because of this fact, most people in these regions speak Spanish. Spanish touches can be seen in regions' art, food, music, and more. Independence Day. On July 4, 1776, the American colonies declared their freedom from Britain. Since then, July 4th has been known in the United States as Independence Day. Each year, people celebrate with parades, picnics, and fireworks. Millions of people in North America enjoy watching and playing baseball and basketball. Soccer is very popular in Mexico and Central America. Hockey is a favorite sport in Canada. North America has many natural resources. Forests that supply timber cover a large part of the land. Farmland throughout the continent produces corn, cotton, soybeans, wheat, and other crops. North America grows more food than any other continent in the world. The continent also has large amounts of coal, copper, iron, oil, natural gas, and silver. Oil and natural gas provide northwestern North America with most of its wealth. The Trans-Alaska pipeline carries oil from the drilling sites to the parts along the coast. Mexico's fruit exports. Mexico is the seventh largest exporter of fresh fruit in the world. Nearly 90% of those exports go to the United States. Mexico's major fruit exports include avocados, grapes, lemons, strawberries, and limes. The leading industry in many Caribbean islands is tourism. In the Bahamas, for example, more than 60% of the country's wealth comes from tourism. The United States is the second largest cotton producer in the world. China is the largest. The heart of North America is often called the world's breadbasket because so much grain is grown there. Transportation. People and goods are moved across North America in three major ways: by water, that is rivers, canals; by land, that is highways and railways; and by air, airplane routes. Bordered by three oceans, North America has many large port cities. Ships transport goods to and from places all over the world. The Golden Gate Bridge in the United States, city of San Francisco, is a very important transportation link. It connects San Francisco with places to the north. About 40 million vehicles cross the Golden Gate Bridge every year. Here are some of North America's special places of interest.